What's up, guys? Corey here, out by the lake, getting ready to do some carpet cleaning. I wasn't sent out here to do cleaning. I was sent out here to do some repair, and I'm gonna show you what I was asked to do, and then what I suggested we do instead. So, hang on, let me show you.
What I was asked to do, I drug the carpet outside. It was right there. What they asked me to do was to patch in a piece of that carpet. I think it came out of there, out of the living room. It's got wood in there. They asked me to patch a piece of carpet in here because it looked like this was getting too much wear on it. Told him, you don't have a wear issue. You have a dirty carpet issue. And he said, well, it's just been cleaned. I said, well, the problem is it's not clean. This carpet is not clean. And the risk to benefit of me cutting this out just to make, you know, more money won't fix his problem. I would make about three times as much if I were to cut this out and do as he asked. And coming from a used piece over there that came out of that room there, the risk to benefit is too far off for me to morally do that. You know, I've been doing it for 20 years, and I know that the risk and benefit is off. It might look better. It could even look a little worse, but for what it costs to do that, as opposed to have me clean it and fix the problem that way, it just doesn't make sense. So I'm going to clean these three rooms here, and we're going to make them actually clean. We're going to make them actually clean and fix the problem that way. So I've got somebody who showed up that's gonna help me carry that carpet downstairs. I'll be back to start the video here in a bit. All right, guys, first thing we're gonna do is we're gonna vacuum here with the Royal. I've been meaning to switch out vacuums here, but we're still out of today. I've gotta vacuum up that, and I'm gonna vacuum up all of this carpet stuff that came off that big roll of carpet to get that out of here. There's guests checking in, I think, Saturday or something. So we're gonna make it look all clean and shiny for them, and those other carpet guys that have been out here, I don't know about them anymore.
right, update here. I pre-sprayed this room. It's already looking cleaner and lighter. However, in pre-spraying the room, I'll show you what happened. The bolts broke on my sprayer here. So, handle came off. That'll speed you up considerably, but he switched to this guy right here. Then, spraying with this guy, doing some spot spraying, the top came off, spilled it all over the creation. So, you know, things really going just completely the hell in a handbasket on the third floor here. So anyway, now I'm gonna clean this guy and turn the fan on high and get it to dry here. So let me clean it first, then we'll come back and take a look. But I don't know if we're gonna see any actual cleaning because I've wasted so much time going up and down the stairs and the elevator and everything else. I'll be back. All right, show a little bit here. I've cleaned a little bit. I'm gonna show basically. I think it's another one of those cases to where it's a lot of residue that was left behind by probably a steam cleaner. So you can see what I'm doing to it. I'm powering right through it with ammonia and with hydrogen peroxide. So I'm gonna bring it back white again. Hopefully nothing else will break during the time I'm trying to do this. I'm liable to just lose my mind. I'm gonna finish this out real quick. This room is done. I'm glad I can vlog all this and share this with all my YouTube people. Something else stupid just happened to me here. But anyway, this looks just absolutely pristine. This is what you're looking for here. Got the fan, I changed the direction when it was going. In winter mode, it was going backwards, so I changed it where it's blowing down so you get a faster dry time. So anyway, we're good here. Now, in pre-spraying the second room, man, just get the whole thing pre-sprayed here. So I'm getting ready to clean it and change out towels on the machine and do that. But while I was pre-spraying the room, this happens. I mean, damn it, that's my last sprayer, for Christ's sakes. So what I've got to hope now, that when you shove this guy down in here, you know, it'll still work. I just don't think you can unscrew it anymore. So I don't think you can add any solution to it. That leaves me down to maybe something like that in order to finish out the job with. So, to give yourself an idea, you know, how some days can go. That sprayer's breaking down left and right. I'm on the third floor. It's just, you never know what to expect. It's unpredictable when you're in business by yourself, for yourself. There's no boss to call, nobody to come save you. You know, you're on your own. So, something to consider when you're wanting to start your own small business. You are on your own. It's an eat what you kill world. You can go home and pout and whine about it and not get paid, or you can find a way to make it happen. And I've been doing it for 20 years, finding a different way to make it happen. I've got to drive to, you know, Home Depot and buy a new sprayer for, you know, spray 3 inches of carpet. I guess that's what I got to do. That's just the way it works when you're in a small business all by yourself. Nobody to save you. All right, good. Do my best to clean that one before something else catches on fire or blows up out here. You never know. Be right back. I'm not going to record it because I'm liable to record something stupid at it. All right. Got this one clean. Got the fan running. Hurry up and dry it. So turned out absolutely perfect. This is exactly what you're looking for. In a VLM carpet cleaning. So we got two down. We got one to go. Bar something completely catastrophic, I should be able to do one more room. But I'm almost afraid to get in traffic and drive out of here, for Christ's sake. Gotta go downtown Austin next. And with the kind of luck I'm having right now, I don't want to be anywhere near downtown Austin and all the traffic down there. Just stupid things are happening right now. All right, I'm gonna pre-spray this however I can manage to, and then clean it, and hopefully I can pull off just one more room here. Over here, let me show this. This is, I don't really know what that is, but it's something dye related, so thinking the ammonia would probably power that out. I don't know. 50-50 shot on that. We'll see. All right. Now I'm going to pre-spray that whole thing. All right. Now in conclusion here. Got this room done. The little bit of pink paint, I couldn't get it all to come out. It looks better. It's not perfect. You can still see some pink over there a little bit. But we are all back to good here. The carpet is in not really in any notable state of wear. I don't see it being a problem whatsoever. So I'm proud to say I've saved this guy, I don't know, about $150, $160 off what he was going to spend with me by just doing my job differently and actually cleaning the carpet. Everybody wants to be a carpet cleaner, but not everybody wants to get your carpet clean. It takes additional effort and time to get your carpet clean. Most people are coming out here for a paycheck. That's why they're doing it. Not because they want to excel and get another 5-star review and another video on YouTube showing the validity of their service. All right, guys, I appreciate you watching the video. I'm gonna try to get whatever I got out of here and back down to the van before anything else breaks or I get snake bitten. You never know. I don't think I've had this many sprayers break down in just one time in years. But man, I've got to go looking out the window right now. It's love to be fishing right up there right now. Looking at the lake, I'm on Lake Travis. Anyway, I've got to go either buy a new sprayer or I can probably find some bolts that will bolt the handle back on the one that broke. Anyway, I've got one more cleaning coming up today in downtown Austin, which is so far away from here, you wouldn't even believe it. Thanks for watching, guys, and God bless. See you on the next video.